commit yourself into the hands of the Lord. Say, Lord, make a way for me today. Make a way for me today. Make a way. Make a free the word. Free your word. Speak to me. Speak to me. Speak to me. Speak to me. Let your word fall on good ground. Let your word fall on good ground. That's your prayer. Lord, let your word fall on good ground. Let your word fall on good ground. Let your word transform me. Let your word empower me. Lord, lift me up by your word. Encourage me by your word. Teach me by your word. Empower me. Heal me by your word. Deliver me by your word. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Father. We bless you. We worship you. We honor you. Holy Spirit, grant utterance, insight, breathe upon your children. Father, when all is said and done, we know our life will be better because we interacted with your word. We thank you and we bless you in Jesus' name. What is the name I am? So in the month of October, we've been hammering on the grace for discipleship. Because it's an instruction from the Lord. It's an instruction from the Lord. The Bible is majority of the Bible is instructions. And the instructions you follow.
Y esas instrucciones las seguimos.
And that you which you practice
y eso que practica,
will bring you the results.
Les va a traer resultado.
It's not only what you believe,
no es simplemente lo que crean,
but it's what you practice.
Sino lo que practican.
So let's look at what Jesus said.
Vamos a ver lo que decía Jesús.
In Matthew chapter 28,
en Mateo 28,
verse 18.
Versículo 18.
And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the age. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
So what was the command that Jesus gave to his people?
¿Qué fue el mandamiento que dio Jesús?
Go into all nations.
Vayan a las naciones.
And what do you do when you go there?
¿Y qué hacen cuando vayan ahí?
Make disciples.
Hacer discípulos.
So we have an assignment to do what? To make disciples.
Tenemos la tarea de convertir discípulos.
And that's one of the mission statements of us as a church.
Y eso es un enfoque de nuestra iglesia.
To create the atmosphere,
crear la atmósfera,
where we can raise disciples,
donde pueden crecerse los discípulos.
So it is our core mission as a ministry.
Ese es un propósito de nuestra misión.
To raise people to become disciples.
Crear discípulos.
And sometimes we can throw out a word all over.
Y a veces podemos dar una palabra.
And someone will say, okay, so who is a disciple?
Y luego quizás digan, pues entonces, ¿quién es discípulo?
All right, let me look through scriptures.
Vamos a ver la escritura.
I want to look at the model that Jesus used.
Vamos a ver el modelo que dio Jesús.
Let's look at Matthew chapter 4.
Mateo 4.
Matthew chapter 4, verse 18.
Versículo 18. Mateo 4, 18.
Matthew 4, 18. And we'll be opening scripture little by little, so get familiar with the Bible today. Matthew 4, 18. And Jesus, walking by the Sea of Galilee, saw two brothers, Simon, called Peter, and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. 19. Then he said to them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. They immediately left their nets and followed him. So Jesus saw these men who were fishing.
Jesús vio a estos hombres que estaban de pesca.
And he said, I have a better job for you.
Y les dijo, tengo un mejor trabajo para vosotros.
And what is your job?
¿Y qué era su trabajo?
Go make men, go catch men for me.
Ir ser pescador de hombre.
So we're looking at one definition of who a disciple is.
Estamos viendo una definición de quién es un discípulo.
But when Jesus called them,
cuando Jesús les llamó,
he didn't leave them alone.
No los dejó solos.
He did something to them.
Hizo algo con ellos.
Let's look at Mark chapter 3.
Vamos a Marco 3.
We're going to look at what Jesus did to them. Mark chapter 3.
¿Qué hizo Jesús a Marco 3.
Marco 3, 14.
3:14.
Then he appointed 12 that they might be with him, that he might send them out to preach and to have power to heal sicknesses and to cast out demons. So, what did Jesus do when he brought them to himself?
Entonces, ¿qué hizo Jesús cuando se los trajo a él mismo?
He equipped them.
Él los equipó.
So, to make a disciple,
para convertir un discípulo,
there's a process of catching them.
Hay un proceso de cautarlos.
And there's a process of what? Of equipping them.
Y luego prepararlos.
Bible says that he brought them to himself.
La palabra dice que se los trajo a sí mismo.
That he will give them the resources
para que él le diera los recursos
to heal the sick.
Para sanar a los
enfermos. And to drive out demons.
Y para sacar fuera los demonios.
Somebody said, I have the power.
Alguien me dijo, yo tengo el poder.
So the goal that God has for you,
la meta que Dios tiene para ti,
is that when he calls you,
es que cuando te llame,
he will equip you.
Él también te va a dar todo lo que requiere. No están sin poder.
You have power.
Tienen poder.
Let's look at what Jesus did on the road.
Vamos a ver qué hizo Jesús en el camino.
Matthew chapter 10.
Mateo 10.
Matthew chapter 10 verse 1.
Mateo 10, 1.
Read the Bible with me. Matthew chapter 10 verse 1. And when he had called his 12 disciples to him, he gave them power over unclean spirits to cast them out, and to heal all sicknesses and all diseases. The Bible lists the name of the disciples, right? But verse 5 says that these 12 Jesus sent out and instructed them, saying, do not go into the way of the Gentiles. Do not enter into a city of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lordship of the house of Israel. And as you go, preach, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out demons. Freely you have what? Received, freely do what? Give. So what do we see here?
¿Qué es lo que estamos viendo aquí?
Jesus called the disciples to himself.
Jesús le llamó a los discípulos.
And then he gave them something.
Y luego él les entregó algo.
And then he gave them something to go out and give to others.
Y eso que se les entregó era para que fueran a seguir dándolo más adelante.
So I want us to look at the process.
Quiero que vean el proceso.
First, he calls them.
Primero les llama.
Second, he gives them stuff.
Y luego segundo los prepara.
And third, he sends them out.
Y el tercer punto es los manda fuera.
Alright, so who then is a disciple?
Entonces, ¿quién es un discípulo?
A disciple is a learner.
¿Es alguien que aprende?
Is someone who willingly enrolls in a discipline.
¿Es que alguien se pone disciplina voluntariamente?
Is someone who submits to the teachings of that discipline.
¿Alguien que se mete y se sujeta a la disciplina?
And then eventually becomes an expert in that field.
Y que eventualmente se convierte en un experto de esa área.
See, these guys were fishermen.
Estos hombres eran pescadores.
They didn't know how to drive out devils.
Ellos no sabían cómo sacar demonios.
Jesus called them to himself.
Jesús les llamó para que.
And then he taught them.
Y él les enseñó.
And then after he taught them to a point.
Y después de que los enseñó a un punto.
And then he realized that now they could do the job.
Y se dio cuenta que ya podían hacer la obra.
He sent them out.
Los mandó fuera.
So there is a cycle of discipleship.
Hay un ciclo de ser discípulo.
First, there is what? The calling.
Primero el llamado.
Second, there is a training and equipment.
Y luego el entrenamiento y preparación.
And third is what? Is the sending out.
Y luego mandarlos fuera.
So we want to make sure that we cover all those areas.
Vamos a cubrir esas áreas.
Because if we don't do that,
porque si no hacemos eso,
people will just respond to the call.
Entonces la gente responde al llamado.
And then that'll be the end.
Y ahí termina.
But remember that when God calls you as a disciple,
pero recuerden que cuando el Señor les llama,
he doesn't expect you to remain the same way he called you.
No espera que permanezcan así como les llamó.
Let's look at Luke chapter 6.
Vamos a Lucas 6.
Are you learning something today?
¿Están aprendiendo algo?
Luke chapter 6, verse 40.
Lucas 6, 40.
A disciple is not above his teacher, but everyone who is perfectly trained will be like what? His teacher. So everyone who is perfectly trained is expected to grow up to become like his teacher.
Se espera que sean igual que el maestro.
So, is it possible for us to be like Jesus?
¿Es posible ser como Jesús?
I'm asking, is it possible?
Les pregunto, ¿es posible?
Is it possible?
¿Es posible?
Yes, it is possible.
Sí, es.
Because let's look at John chapter 14, verse 12.
Vamos a Juan 14, versículo 12. Juan 14, 12.
Juan 14, 12. John 14, 12. John 14, 12. John 14, 12. Most assuredly I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also, and greater works than these he will do, because I go to my Father. Now, what is Jesus saying?
¿Qué es lo que dice Jesús?
It is possible. Someone says it's possible.
¿Qué es posible?
It is possible that we can act like Jesus.
¿Es posible ser como Jesús?
Why do I say it's possible?
¿Por qué les digo que es posible?
Because Jesus said so.
Porque Jesús lo dijo.
He said that if I submit myself to training,
él dijo, si yo me sujeto al entrenamiento,
I can become as good as my teacher.
Entonces yo puedo ser como mi maestro.
Who happens to be the Holy Spirit?
¿Qué es el Espíritu Santo?
If I submit to his teachings,
si me entrego a sus enseñanzas,
I can do great things that Jesus did.
Entonces puedo hacer las cosas grandes como Jesús.
Because the same Spirit,
porque el mismo Espíritu,
was the Spirit that was working in Jesus.
Fue el que obraba en Jesús.
And that's the same Spirit that we have also contacted.
Y es el mismo Espíritu que nosotros tenemos con comunicación.
Someone say same Spirit.
Alguien diga, es el mismo Espíritu.
It's not different.
No es diferente.
The Holy Spirit who came upon Jesus,
el Espíritu Santo que fue sobre Jesús,
who gave him the ability to do great things,
que le entregó la habilidad de hacer cosas grandes,
is the same Holy Spirit we received when we became believers.
Es el mismo Espíritu Santo que se le entregó cuando fue creyente.
Somebody say same Spirit. I want to drill that thing inside of you.
Quiero enfocarnos en eso y que lo entiendas.
So that you don't have any inferiority mindset.
Para que ya no tengan ese pensar que son menos.
Jesus is our big brother.
Jesús es nuestro hermano grande.
We have been begotten by the Father.
Somos recibidos por el Padre.
The same grace.
La misma gracia.
That went through Jesus.
Que obró por Jesús.
The same grace that we have also contacted.
Es la misma gracia que nosotros tenemos.
And we have to go out and work.
Y tenemos que ir fuera y obrar.
Like Jesus worked.
Igual que Jesús.
The disciples came around Jesus.
Los discípulos fueron alrededor de Jesús.
And then he equipped them.
Y él los preparó.
And then he sent them out.
Y luego los mandó fuera.
The same thing must happen to us.
Lo mismo tiene que suceder con nosotros.
We have been called.
Nos ha llamado el Señor.
And we have been equipped.
Y nos ha preparado.
It's time for us to do or go out.
Es tiempo de ir fuera.
Somebody say it's time.
Alguien diga es tiempo.
Now listen. I mean, if you enroll in the nursing school.
Y escuchen, si se envuelven en una clase de enfermería.
And 20 years you are still in that school.
Y si 20 años después aún están en esa clase.
Something is wrong.
Algo está mal.
When are you going to graduate?
¿Cuándo vas a graduar?
At some point you must go out.
A un punto tienen que ir fuera.
And become a nurse.
Y ser una enfermera.
And then you graduate in the, you grow up in the process.
Y luego creces en el proceso.
The same way in our faith.
Lo mismo en la fe.
We must grow up.
Tenemos que crecer.
In our discipleship. So we can be useful to God. So a disciple is one, an imitator of his teacher.
El discípulo imita a su maestro.
Because you must imitate your master.
Tienes que imitar a tu maestro.
If you don't imitate your master,
si no lo haces,
I mean you will not learn the tricks of the trade.
No vas a aprender cómo ser.
Let's look at 1 Corinthians chapter 11.
Vamos a Primera de Corintios, Corintios 11.
1 Corinthians 11.
Primera de Corintios 11.
First Corinthians 11:1. It says that imitate me just as I also imitate Christ. Paul was saying,
Pablo decía,
imitate me.
Imítenme.
So for you to be a disciple,
para que se convierta en discípulo,
you must learn to imitate your master.
Tiene que aprender a imitar a su maestro.
Let's look at what Jesus said.
Vamos a ver cómo, ¿qué dijo Jesús?
Matthew 11:28.
Mateo 11:28.
I want to be flipping your Bibles.
Quiero que empiecen a moverse por la escritura.
Matthew 11:28. I want to follow.
Mateo 11:28.
Matthew 11:28. Come to me, all ye who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. So what did Jesus say? Learn from me. So a disciple is an imitator and a learner. You learn the boldness of your master.
Aprendes la confianza de tu maestro.
That is what the disciples did.
Es lo que hicieron los discípulos.
They learned how Jesus was fearless.
Aprendieron cómo Jesús no tenía temor.
Let's look at Acts chapter 4.
Vamos a Hechos 4.
Acts chapter 4.
Hechos 4.
Acts chapter 4 verse 13.
Versículo 13.
Acts 4:13. Now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John, and perceived that they were uneducated and untrained men, they marveled, and they realized that they had been with Jesus. Now, so the Pharisees,
el faraón,
they saw Peter and John.
Vio a Pedro y a Juan.
And then they look at these guys.
Y los ven.
They have not been to our school before.
Todavía no han ido al entrenamiento.
But we see that they are walking boldly.
Pero los ven que caminan con mucha confianza.
But the Bible said,
pero la palabra dice,
they realized
que se dieron cuenta
that these guys had been hanging around Jesus.
Que ellos habían estado con Jesús.
What is my point?
¿Qué es mi punto?
When you hang around Jesus,
cuando te reúnes con Jesús,
your boldness will shock the world.
Tu confianza va a ponerle temor al mundo.
So if your world is not shocked about your boldness,
si tu mundo no tiene temor de tu confianza,
if you are living in timidity,
si estás viviendo con temor,
it means you are not yet caught up the training of Jesus.
Quiere decir que no has recibido ese entrenamiento de Jesús.
If you enroll in this ministry, you will have to catch the boldness that we operate with as a ministry.
Tienes que recibir esa confianza que tenemos como ministerio.
Because everything that we do,
porque todo lo que hacemos,
we don't do out of fear.
No pasamos con temor.
We do out of confidence in God.
Pasamos en confianza en el Señor.
I mean, like we look at our size.
Si vemos nuestro tamaño,
we look at the years that we've been around.
Vemos los años que hemos empezado.
We say we're going to believe God to build.
Y vamos a creer en el Señor a construir.
People say, you are losing your mind.
Y gente dice,
I remember many people were telling me,
pastor,
not in this house,
en esta casa no.
I'm talking outside this
en
house,
gente.
Why don't you rent a little bit?
¿Por qué no rentas un periodo?
And then spend time a little bit so, I mean, you can grow more.
Y luego puedes pasar tiempo para crecer más.
I said, that is madness.
Y yo le dije, no, estás loco.
Why do I have to throw my money away?
¿Para qué voy a tirar mi dinero?
In leasing.
En estar rentando.
When I can invest my money in market. I said, no way.
Dije, no.
I said, thank you for your advice.
Por su,
but if I look at what we're looking for,
pero si busco y lo que estamos
there
buscando,
is no sense in leasing.
No hay sentido en estar rentando.
And it didn't make sense to me.
No me tenía con sentido.
And you're going to look at the people who are here.
Y si van a ver la gente que está aquí,
I was like, where are we going to find money from?
Dice, pregunta, ¿dónde vamos a ir el dinero?
But God supplies.
Come
and say, God supplies. This is the confidence that you must have.
Esa es la confianza que tiene que tener.
To approach your business.
Para ir con tu negocio.
The Lord is laying some business ideas into your mind.
El Señor ya les está dando las ideas de negocio.
And you do your budget.
Y hacen sus cálculos.
It doesn't add up.
Y no les tiene la cuenta.
You don't have any father to give you $30 million.
Si no tienes a padres que te den 30,
but some people, father can give them a loan of $2 million. You don't have a father like that.
Pero tú no lo tienes.
Your father might even want money from you.
Quizás tu padre te pide a ti.
So then you have no are giving me these ideas.
Si me estás dando estas ideas,
you must finance this business.
Entonces, Señor, dame los las finanzas para esto.
Bring him into the boat.
Tráeme todo.
Challenge him.
Dame la
presa. He says, try me and see.
El Señor dice, trátame y verás.
If I will not open the windows of heaven,
a ver si no te abro los cielos,
and pour you out a blessing,
y derramo bendición.
If God wants to do something,
si el Señor quiere hacer algo,
he doesn't need the help of man.
Él no requiere la asistencia del humano.
Get that into your system.
Reciban eso en su sistema.
God will do it.
El Señor lo hará
with his resources.
Él con sus recursos.
And so when you begin to hang out around us,
cuando se empiezan a juntar con nosotros,
you must catch that spirit.
Ustedes tienen que recibir ese espíritu.
The doctor can give you a diagnosis.
El doctor te da un diagnóstico.
And we tell you.
Y te diremos,
I'm not a medical doctor.
No soy doctor.
But I know a man.
Pero yo conozco un hombre.
He's a doctor of doctors.
Es un doctor de doctores.
He can heal you.
Y él te sana.
He can deliver you.
Él te libera.
He can restore you.
Él te restaura.
I'm going to believe for you.
Y él te libera.
We go to our prayer church. But as we've been hanging around for these years,
así que nos hemos juntado estos años,
I want to see that operating inside of you.
Quiero ver eso operar en tu vida.
And that's why I'm giving these books to you.
Es por eso que les doy esos libros.
So you don't have any excuse that I don't have money to buy.
No tienen excusa que no lo pudieron comprar.
It's been paid for.
Ya fue pagado.
So you take it,
recíbelo,
read it,
léelo,
enjoy it,
disfrútalo,
and go out and practice it.
Y ve fuera y practícalo.
If somebody is sick,
si alguien está enfermo,
say, pray for you.
Y pregúnteles, ¿puedo orar?
And then you will leave the name of Jesus for that.
Y empezó a darles el nombre del Señor.
Say, in the name of Jesus.
Y declaro en el nombre de Jesús que está.
And allow God to do what only He can do.
Y permite a Dios que haga lo que solo Él puede.
Such boldness is what God requires of us.
Esta confianza es lo que requiere el Señor de nosotros.
Then look at the boldness of Peter.
Miren la confianza de Pedro.
And they realize that this guy has not been to high school.
Y se requiere y piensan, este no ha ido ni a la primaria.
He's not been to college.
Ni ha ido al colegio.
From where does he get wisdom?
¿De dónde recibe esa sabiduría?
God is the source of wisdom.
Dios es el recurso de la sabiduría.
God is the source of wisdom.
Dios es el recurso de la sabiduría.
Bible calls the Holy Spirit the Spirit of wisdom.
La palabra le llama al Espíritu Santo el Espíritu de sabiduría.
The Spirit of counsel.
El Espíritu de consejo.
The Spirit of knowledge.
El Espíritu de conocimiento.
The Spirit that knows things that ordinary minds do not know.
El Espíritu que reconoce lo que la mente no puede.
And that is what Paul could write and say.
Es por eso que Pablo podía escribir y decir,
no eye has seen.
Que ni un ojo ha visto.
No ear has heard.
Ni el oído ha escuchado.
Neither has any heart imagined.
Ni un corazón ha deseado.
What God wants to do for his children.
Lo que el Señor quiere hacer para sus hijos.
You have no idea what God is about to do
no
for you.
No tienen idea lo que el Señor quiere hacer para ustedes.
Hang around with the Holy Spirit.
Pasen tiempo con el Espíritu Santo.
He's the one who will show you things that nobody has any idea of.
Él es el que te va a revelar cosas que nadie sabe.
Imitate God.
Imita a Dios.
Imitate your pastor.
Imita a tu pastor.
Imitate those who have gone ahead of you.
Imita a aquellos que han ido delante de ti.
Learn from them.
Aprende de ellos.
And operate in that same boldness.
Y opera en esa misma confianza.
And watch what God will do for you.
Mira lo que el Señor va a hacer.
In Acts chapter 11 verse 26.
En Hechos 11:27.
Bible says that in Antioch.
La palabra dice que en una ciudad.
People begin to see, people saw the disciples do amazing things.
El pueblo empezó a ver a los discípulos hacer cosas maravillosas.
And then they started calling them Christians.
Y luego les empezaron a llamar cristianos.
Why would they call them Christians?
¿Por qué les llamaban cristianos?
Because they were behaving like Christ.
Porque se estaban comportando como Cristo.
My prayer,
mi oración,
is that at your workplace,
es que en su trabajo,
in your home,
en su hogar,
anywhere you find yourself,
donde sea que esté,
that you will be known as a Christian.
Que también los identifiquen como.
Not because you come to church on Sunday,
no porque vienen a la iglesia domingo,
but because you work the words of Christ.
Porque obra las palabras del Señor.
That because the anointing of God flows through you.
Porque tiene la unción del Señor fluyendo.
Because when you go to a place,
porque vas a un lugar,
you bring solutions.
Y traes soluciones.
Listen, we must go beyond announcing our presence with a cross.
Tenemos que ir más allá que poner nuestra presencia con una cruz.
We must announce our presence with results.
Tenemos que traer resultados.
And I declare upon you,
yo les declaro,
that the grace is coming upon your
que
life.
La gracia del Señor está sobre su vida.
That will cause you to bring produce results in Jesus' name.
Va a causar que traigan resultados en el nombre de Jesús.
You will never be barren again.
Nunca serán escasez.
You will have pure results.
Tendrán puro resultado.
In Jesus'
name. En el nombre de Jesús.
Who is a disciple?
Entonces, ¿quién es un discípulo?
A disciple is someone who practices what he's been taught.
Es alguien que practica lo que les ha enseñado.
And the second is the word practitioner.
Es aquel que aplica.
Yes. Many of us believe.
Muchos creemos.
I believe.
Yo creo.
I receive.
Lo recibo.
But we don't practice.
Pero no lo aplican.
If there's trouble one day,
si hay problemas un día,
the first thing that comes out of our mouth,
la primera cosa que sale de nuestra boca,
oh, I'm dead.
Ay, me voy a morir.
Everything is against me.
Es un fracaso.
You're not practicing what you believe.
No están practicando lo que creen.
Do you believe that God can bring you out?
¿O creen que el Señor los va a sacar adelante?
If you believe it,
si lo creen,
and there's a problem,
y hay un problema,
don't start killing yourself.
Entonces no te empieces a matar.
You rise up and say,
levántate y di.
The Lord is my shepherd.
El Señor es mi pastor.
I shall not want.
Y nada me faltará.
He makes me lie down in green pastures.
Él me lleva a los pastores verdes.
I'm at this place.
Yo estoy en este lugar.
It might look dry.
Y quizás esté seco.
But it's green pastures.
Pero son pastores verdes.
Because the Lord has placed
porque
me over here. The Lord will answer me.
El Señor me va a contestar.
The Lord will make a way for
me. El Señor me va a abrir camino.
Even where there seems to be no way.
Donde no se vea,
the Lord will make a way.
El Señor me hará un.
That is you practicing what you believe.
Eso es practicando y aplicando lo que creen.
Something is happening.
Algo está sucediendo.
Your children are acting out.
Sus hijos están comportando mal.
Say, Lord,
pídenle, Señor,
we are in covenant.
Estamos en tu pacto.
This promise.
Esta promesa
is for me.
Es para mí.
And my children's children.
Y mis hijos y los hijos de.
I don't look at what the devil is doing.
Yo no veo lo que el enemigo está haciendo.
They belong to you.
Son tuyos, Señor. Te pertenecen. Es algo terminado.
And watch what God will do.
Y van a ver lo que el Señor hace.
So we have to practice what we believe.
Tenemos que aplicar lo que aprendemos.
Let's look at John 8:31.
Vamos a Juan 8:31.
John 8:31.
Juan 8:31.
John 8:31 says, then Jesus said to the Jews who believed him, if you continue in my word, you are my disciples indeed. John 8:31.
Juan 8:31.
He said that if you continue,
la palabra dice que si continúas,
if you remain,
si te permaneces,
if you practice,
si aplicas,
so a disciple is not someone who comes to church on Sunday.
El discípulo no es alguien que venga a la iglesia el domingo.
A disciple is somebody who practices the word of God.
Es alguien que aplica la palabra del Señor.
The devil is never afraid of a church, a Sunday church goer.
El enemigo no le tiene temor a alguien que va a la iglesia el domingo.
The devil is afraid of a word practitioner.
Teme aquel que aplica la palabra del Señor.
When you begin to practice the word,
cuando empiezas a aplicar la palabra del Señor,
you become a threat to the kingdom of the devil.
Entonces vas a ser un amenaza. Thank you. Vas a ser una amenaza para el enemigo.
You become a threat to the kingdom of the devil.
Es una amenaza.
You become a danger to the enemy.
Vas a ser una amenaza al enemigo.
The enemy cannot handle you.
El enemigo ya no va.
And I pray today
hoy,
that you live here with a commitment,
que se vayan aquí con un compromiso,
that I'm going to practice the word,
yo voy a aplicar la palabra del Señor,
and I'm going to be a danger to the devil.
Y voy a ser una amenaza al enemigo.
That's all you need.
Es todo lo que
necesito. Practice the word.
Aplicar la palabra.
And the enemy automatically
y el enemigo automáticamente se va.
So when you practice the word,
cuando aplicas la palabra,
you become the word.
Te conviertes en la palabra.
And that is when you begin to function as a disciple.
Y ahí es donde obras como discípulo.
Who has been trained.
Ya fue entrenado perfectamente.
We want to have people in this church.
Queremos tener en esta iglesia.
Who are trained perfectly.
Aquellos discípulos que están entrenados perfectamente.
That at any single day.
En cualquier día.
Anybody can be called on to preach.
Cualquier se puede llamar a venir a predicar.
At any single day.
En cualquier momento.
We can call somebody to go and start a branch somewhere.
Podemos llamar que empiecen una iglesia donde sea.
At any single day.
En cualquier momento.
We can send you a text to go to this office and pray for somebody.
Estamos a orar por
algo. Because that is what God has called us to do.
Porque eso es lo que el Señor nos llamó a hacer.
But we can only get there.
Pero nomás podemos llegar
when
ahí.
When we practice it.
Cuando lo aplicamos.
I want to look at an example of a practice in the Bible.
Vamos a ver un ejemplo en la escritura.
Acts chapter 3.
Hechos 3.
Acts chapter 3.
Hechos 3.
Verse 4.
Versículo 4.
When you read from verse 1, it's about a cripple who was lying by the gate.
Cuando empiezan los inicios. La escritura dice que es de un hombre que no caminaba y estaba en el portón.
And then he asked Peter and John for money.
Y él estaba pidiendo una limosna a Pedro y a Juan.
But Peter and John realized,
pero ellos se dieron cuenta.
This guy doesn't need money.
Este señor no requiere dinero.
This guy needs healing.
Requiere una sanidad.
And they had been with Jesus.
Y ellos habían estado con Jesús.
And Jesus was always healing the sick.
Y Jesús siempre sanaba a los enfermos.
So listen to what they did.
Escuchen lo que vieron.
Verse 4. And fixing his eyes on him,
with John, Peter said, "Look at us." So he gave them his attention, expecting to receive something from them. Then Peter said, "Silver and gold I do not have, but what I have I give you. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, rise up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and his ankle bones received strength. So he lifting up, stood up, walked and entered the temple, and walking, leaping, and praising God. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now, Peter and John,
Pedro y Juan,
had been with Jesus before.
Ya habían estado con Jesús.
And they saw Jesus heal the sick.
Y miraron cómo sanaba a los enfermos.
So when they saw someone who was sick,
cuando vieron a alguien enfermo,
he said, "In the name of the Lord Jesus, rise up and walk." That's what we expect you to do. If something is wrong, don't be quick to call the whole world.
No le llame a todo el mundo.
Rise up.
Levántense.
And say, "In the name of Jesus."
Y digan en el nombre de Jesús.
I command you, evil spirit, out of this place.
Pero que este espíritu feo salga.
I declare you healed in Jesus' name.
Te declaro que estás sano.
And watch what God will do for you.
Y vean lo que el Señor hace.
A disciple also understand the demands and provision of the discipline.
Entiende los requisitos para la obra.
Luke 14:25.
De Lucas 4:25.
No, 14.
14:25.
Luke 14:25. It's a long passage.
Lucas 14:25.
It says that now great multitude went to him, and he turned and said to them, "If anyone comes to me and does not hate his father and mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, yes, his own life also, he cannot be my disciple. And whoever does not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. For which of you, intending to build a tower, does not sit down first and count the cost, whether he has enough to finish it? Lest after he has laid a foundation and is able to finish, all who see it begin to mock him, saying, 'This man began to build and was not able to finish.' Or what king, going to make war against another king, does not sit down first and consider whether he is able with 10,000 to meet him who comes against him with 20,000? Or else, while the other is still a great way off, he sends a delegation and asks conditions of peace. So likewise, whoever of you does not forsake all that he has cannot be my disciples." Right? So Jesus was giving them instructions.
Jesús les estaba dando instrucciones.
You cannot build without planning.
No puedes construir sin planear.
And you cannot go to war without planning.
No puedes ir a la guerra sin primero planear.
You cannot wake up one day and say that I want to be a medical doctor without counting the cost that it's going to take.
No te puedes levantar un día y decir quiero ser doctor y no considerar todos los gastos.
You can't say that I want to be a police officer without counting the cost of being a police officer.
No puedes querer ser un policía sin ver todos los gastos.
I want to be a teacher. You need to count the cost.
Tienes que apuntar todos los gastos para ser maestro.
You might be dealing with teenagers with hormones.
Quizás vas a trabajar con los jóvenes que están con muchas hormonas.
And then you can't deal with your hormonal issues.
Quizás no pienses que estés preparado para eso.
You might end up killing them one day in the office.
Quizás un día te van a llegar a tope.
So you need to plan and look at the dangers of the career you are choosing.
Tienes que ver todos los peligros de cualquier carrera que quieres.
The same way with your calling as a believer.
En la misma manera con tu llamado como creyente.
If you want to enroll to be a disciple,
si te quieres inscribir a ser un discípulo,
sit down and ask yourself,
siéntate y pregúntate,
what are the demands?
¿Qué es lo que se requiere?
What are the requirements?
¿Qué se requiere de
ti? And what are the provisions?
¿Qué son las provisiones?
What are the rewards?
¿Qué son las recompensas?
For this calling I'm responding to.
Por este llamado que estoy respondiendo. haciendo.
I can tell you one thing.
Te diré una cosa.
That this calling is very demanding.
Que este llamado tiene muchos requisitos.
But it's also very, very rewarding.
Pero también tiene mucho recompensa.
It is very, very rewarding.
Sí, lo es.
The Lord said that, "Lo, I am with you always."
El Señor dice, siempre estoy contigo.
I mean, can you imagine?
Imagínense.
You are making a stand and you're walking with God.
Te tomas un paso y ahí está Dios
contigo. You are never alone.
Nunca estás solo.
Even when you are walking through the valley of the shadow of death,
aún cuando estés en el valle de la sombra de muerte,
you are never alone.
Nunca estás solo.
So that I will never leave you nor forsake you.
La palabra es que nunca te dejará ni te soltará, nunca se quitará de tu camino.
He says, "I will help you."
Dice que él te ayudará.
I will hold your hand.
Él te va a sostener.
So that everything you need for godliness, I'll provide it for you.
Todo lo que requieras, él te lo va a proveer.
So the good news is,
las buenas nuevas son,
no matter the challenge you face,
no importa la reta,
you're going in as a winner.
Ya vas a entrar.
Amen. Somebody say, "I'm a winner."
Alguien diga, "Yo soy ganador."
I mean, that's a beauty.
Eso es lo bueno.
It's like a match that has been fixed. The results have been fixed already.
Es como una prueba que ya terminó y ganó.
You might have to run over or run around the field for a while.
Quizás tendrá que entrenar.
And it's going to be tiring.
Y se va a cansar.
But you know the results already.
Pero ya sabes los resultados.
That is the calling God has called us in.
Eso es el llamado que el Señor nos hace.
John 16:33.
Juan 16:33.
Jesus told the disciples.
Jesús le dijo a los discípulos.
He said that in this world,
en este mundo,
you have trouble.
Van a tener problemas.
In this world,
en este mundo,
you have persecution.
Van a tener persecuciones.
Then he says, "Cheer up."
Pero le dice, "Alégrate."
Then to your neighbor, say, "Cheer up."
Cheer up.
Say, "Cheer up."
Cheer up.
Why do you have to cheer up?
¿Por qué se tienen que animar?
Because I have overcome.
Porque ya soy sobresaliente.
Someone say, "I'm an overcomer." So briefly, I want to look at the cost of discipleship.
Vamos a ver los costos de ser discípulo.
Next week, I'll look at the rewards of discipleship.
La semana que entra vamos a ver la recompensa. Hoy vamos a ver los costos.
So if the cost is scaring you,
si acaso se les mete temor hoy en ver lo que les cuesta,
come next week and look at the rewards.
Vengan la semana que entra y vean las recompensas.
And you realize that the cost is little.
Y se van a dar cuenta que el costo es muy poco.
I love what the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 4.
Me encanta la palabra de Hebreos 12.
The Bible says, "Looking to Jesus."
Dice, mirando a Jesús.
The author and perfecter of our faith.
El que hace perfecto nuestra fe.
Who for the joy of the reward that was set before him, he despised the cross. The cross was nothing to him.
Para él, la cruz no fue nada.
Because he knew it was temporary.
Porque él sabía que era algo temporal.
And most of us,
muchos de nosotros,
we make adjustments.
Hacemos ajustes.
That's going to affect our eternity.
Que me va a afectar en esta eternidad.
When all we're dealing with are just temporal issues.
Porque todo lo que estamos pasando son cosas temporales.
Don't do that.
No hagan eso.
Don't sell eternity.
No cambien su eternidad.
For temporary troubles.
Por cosas que son temporales.
Don't be like Esau.
No sean como Esau.
Bible says, just for a bowl of noodles.
Que por darle una comida.
So menudo is the Bible. Just for a bowl of menudo.
Por una comida.
He sold his birthright.
Él le vendió a su hermano.
He just couldn't resist the aroma.
Le dio todo a su hermano.
That will not be your story.
Eso no será su cuento.
Look at the price ahead of you.
Miren la recompensa más allá.
And make the right decision.
Y hagan la decisión correcta.
So what is the cost of discipleship?
¿Qué es lo que les cuesta?
The first is that you have to leave.
Lo primero es que se tienen que ir.
You have to cut off all ties.
Tienen que quitar toda conexión con lo breve.
Burn your bridge.
Quemen el puente.
People say that don't burn bridges.
Hay mucha gente que dice no quemen los puentes.
But when you become a disciple,
cuando se convierten en discípulos,
burn your bridge.
Quemen ese puente.
Why you tell yourself?
¿Qué se dice?
I can't go back again.
Ya no pueden regresar.
Tell them, I said, burn your bridges.
Digan al vecino, quemen sus puentes.
Burn every old bridges.
Todo puente viejo, quemen.
The road that leads to the strip club, burn it.
Aquel camino que los llevaba a la primera de Dios,
the road that leads to the bar, burn it.
Eso que los llevaba a tomar.
The road that leads to your addiction, burn it.
Que los llevaba a la adicción, quemen ese puente.
Don't give any room for it.
No le den lugar.
Burn that bridge.
Quemen ese puente.
When you try to go, you're going to fall down.
Empiezan a caminar para allá, se caen.
So you're not going back again.
Ya no pueden regresar.
Let me read some Old Testament here.
Vamos a ir al Testamento Viejo.
1 Kings chapter 19.
Primera de Reyes 19.
1 Kings chapter 19.
Primera de Reyes 19.
Father, we burn every bridge here.
Padre, quemamos todo
every puente, bad bridge.
Todo puente malo lo quemamos.
We're not going back to it.
No vamos a regresar a ello.
We set your fire in it.
Pues ponemos tu fuego en ese.
Everything that takes us back.
Todo lo que nos lleva atrás.
Back away from where you took us from.
Fuera de donde nos sacaste.
We set it on fire in the name of Jesus.
Lo ponemos en fuego en el nombre
de Jesús. Every bridge of infirmity.
Aquel puente de enfermedad.
Some of us like opening the sickness.
Muchos nos gusta abrir esa puerta de la enfermedad.
We like opening the anxiety door.
Me gusta abrir la puerta a la ansiedad.
The depression door.
La depresión.
We always go back 10 years.
Siempre nos regresamos 10 años.
20 years.
20 años.
And do you remember what you did to me?
Recuerda que me hiciste.
Do you remember what you did to me?
¿Recuerdas que me hiciste eso?
Friend, those bridges. They are in the past.
Están en el pasado.
Don't carry them over.
Ya no los traigan.
If you are forgiven,
si le hemos perdonado,
then let it go.
Entonces déjenme.
It's not time to bring up those things again.
Tiempo de empezar con los.
There is something ahead for
hay
you.
Para usted.
Paul said something.
Pablo dijo algo.
He said that one thing I do.
Dijo una cosa de.
I burn the bridges of the past.
Quemé los puentes del pasado.
Not only burn bad bridges.
No nomás los malos.
Sometimes burn the bridges to your past successes.
También para los éxitos previos.
For some of us, we get stuck in our past successes.
Porque hay veces que nos quedamos permanecidos en esos éxitos previos.
About who I used to be.
Me acuerdo quién yo era.
It's in the past.
Eso ya está en el
get
pasado.
Get
out of it.
Your life is supposed to be better.
Tu vida tiene que ser.
Your best days are ahead of you.
Mejores están adelante.
I said your best days are ahead of you.
Mis días mejores están adelante.
So don't keep dwelling on the past.
No estén enfocándose en el pasado.
In the name of Jesus. First Kings 19:19. So he departed from there and found Elisha the son of Shaphat, who was plowing with 12 yoke of oxen before him, and he was with the 12. Then Elisha passed by and threw his mantle on him, and he left the oxen and ran after Elijah and said, "Please, let me kiss my father and mother, and then I will follow you." And he said to him, "Go back again, for what have I done to you?" 21. So Elisha turned back from him. He took a yoke of oxen and slaughtered them and boiled their flesh. Listen. Using the oxen's equipment, and gave it to the people, and they ate. Then he what? Arose and followed Elijah and became his servant. Can you imagine that?
Imagínense eso.
This guy had a successful farming business.
El señor era un alguien con mucho éxito en lo que es de rancho.
And the Lord sent Elijah.
El señor mandó a Elías.
Go anoint Elisha.
Y le dijo, ve y unge a Eliseo.
As a prophet.
Como profeta.
So Elijah went to anoint Elisha.
Fue a ungirlo.
And Elisha said,
y le dijo,
let me do one last thing.
Déjame hacer una cosa más.
Let me do a party for my family.
Voy a hacer una fiesta para mi familia.
And in that party,
y en esa fiesta,
he took the animal that he was using for his farming.
Él usó esos mismos animales de su rancho.
And then the wood that was an equipment.
Y todo lo que era su equipaje.
He burned all of it.
Lo quemó todo.
What was he saying?
¿Qué estaba haciendo?
I'm done with this farming business.
Dijo, yo ya terminé con esto de rancho.
I'm going on to serve the Lord.
Voy a ir a servir al Señor.
He burned the bridge to the past.
Quemó el puente a su pasado.
There was no way he could go back again.
Ya no había manera de regresar a él.
Because he has burned his equipment.
Ya quemó todo.
He has eaten the oxen already.
Ya quemó todo ganado.
He did a party for the whole community.
Una fiesta para todo el pueblo.
And that was the end of the story.
Ahí fue el fin de su historia.
If you are going to be a disciple,
si van a ser discípulos,
there are certain old ties you need to break them.
Hay ciertas cosas del pasado que tienen que quebrar.
Certain old habits you need to break them.
Hábitos que tienen que dejar atrás.
Maybe you used to keep up with every new show.
Quizás mirabas todos los programas nuevos de la televisión.
You can't do them anymore.
¿Cómo puedes hacer eso?
You cannot. You cannot eat your cake and have it.
No puedes tener tu pastel y comértelo también.
You cannot grow into discipleship.
No puedes ser un discípulo.
When you have so much baggage.
Y tener tanto equipaje.
You drop it over.
Tienes que dejarlo atrás.
And let go of it.
Yeah. Dejarlo.
Luke 9:57.
Lucas 9,
10. Yeah.
57.
Yeah. You make a commitment today.
Van a hacer un compromiso hoy.
To walk with Jesus.
En caminar con Jesús.
And burn every bridge.
Y quemar todo puente.
It's not worth it.
No tiene la
pena. It's going to destroy you.
Los va a destruir.
You will still be in training.
Van a estar en entrenamiento.
20-30 years.
20-30 años.
And people people will come and graduate.
Y la gente va a pasar y graduar.
And then they'll be earning money in their job.
Y van a estar ganando más.
And you'll be jealous.
Y vas a tener celos.
That will not happen to you.
Eso no te va a suceder en el mundo.
I am passionate about this.
Yo tengo una pasión para eso.
Because I know where God is taking us.
Y yo sé dónde el Señor nos está llevando.
And I know God is bringing a multitude.
Y yo sé que el Señor está trayendo multitudes.
And I know when they come and they are committed.
Y yo sé que cuando vengan y tengan ese compromiso.
I don't want you to be jealous.
Yo no quiero que les tengan celos.
When they come,
cuando ellos vengan,
I want them to come learn from you.
Quiero que vengan a aprender de ti.
Because you are positioning yourself.
Porque tú ya te pusiste en posición.
Disciple.
Como discípulo.
And as a trainer.
Y como entrenador.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre del Señor.
Luke 9:57.
Lucas 9:57.
Now it happened that as they journeyed on the road, that someone said to him, Lord, I will follow you wherever you go. He said to him, foxes are holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Then he said to another, follow me. But he said, Lord, let me first go and bury my father. He said to him, let the dead bury their dead, but you go preach the kingdom of God. 61. And another said also, Lord, I will follow you, but let me go first and say bye-bye to my own house. Jesus said, no one, having put his head to the plow and looking back, is fit for the kingdom of God. Jesus said that when you put your head to the plow,
Jesús dijo que cuando pones tu mano en el equipaje,
and then you want to make a straight path,
y quieres hacer un camino derecho,
you cannot look back.
No puedes voltear hacia atrás.
So don't look back.
No miren hacia atrás.
There's a woman in the Bible called Lot's wife.
Hay una mujer en la escritura, la esposa de Lot.
She didn't have a name.
Ella no tenía nombre.
Her name was Lot's wife.
Su nombre era la esposa de Lot.
She looked back.
Ella miró hacia atrás.
When the Lord told her, don't look back.
El Señor le había dicho, no mires hacia atrás.
And the Bible says she became a pillar of salt.
Y la palabra dice que se convirtió en un pilar de sal.
When you look back,
cuando ves atrás,
you get stuck.
Se permanecen ahí.
You get stuck.
Se permanecen.
You become irrelevant.
Ya no tiene nada.
Am I praying for you today? Is that whatever thing is in the past, you let go of it and you put your eyes forward to what God has for you. In the name of Jesus. What is the cost of discipleship? Make God priority. Make Him priority.
Mark 10:21.
Then Jesus, looking at him, loved him and said to him, one thing you lack, go your way, sell whatever you have and give it to the poor, and you have treasures in heaven. And come, take up the cross and follow me. But he was sad at this word and went away sorrowful, for he had great possessions. So there was this man who came to Jesus.
Había un hombre que vino a Jesús.
And I wanted to know how he could be his disciple.
Quería saber cómo convertirse en discípulo.
Jesus told him a lot of things.
Y Dios le dijo muchas cosas.
He said, I've done all these.
Y Jesús de, y él le dijo, ya lo hice.
Since I was a child.
Desde que era niño.
Then Jesus said, okay, there's one last thing.
Entonces Jesús le dijo, una cosa más.
Go sell everything you have.
Ve y vende todo lo que tienes.
Give the money away.
Da el dinero.
And then come follow me.
Y luego ven y me sigues.
And the Bible says the man said no.
Y la palabra dice que el hombre dijo que no.
I cannot leave my goods.
No puedo dejar todos mis bienes.
To become a disciple.
Ser un discípulo de Dios.
It might not necessarily mean that you have to go and sell everything else and give it.
No necesariamente quiere decir que el Señor quiere que vaya y vendan todo.
But you must not worship.
No things that God has blessed you with.
It must be such that at any point in time,
tiene que ser que en cualquier punto,
if you believe God needs it,
si creen que el Señor lo requiere,
you willingly give it to God.
Se lo entrega voluntariamente.
So it's like you have given up ownership already.
Es que si ya se rindieron a él.
Give ownership of your body to God.
Se rinde de todo su cuerpo al Señor.
Give ownership of your children to God.
Se lo entregan sus hijos al Señor.
Give ownership of your properties to God.
Todas sus propiedades se las entregan a él.
At any point in time.
En cualquier punto.
God, if you need it,
si el Señor lo requiere,
you have it.
Es tuyo.
Bible said the man had many possessions.
La palabra dice que el Señor tenía muchos bienes.
And he realized that working with Jesus wasn't that fancy.
Y vio que caminar con Jesús no era tan maravilloso.
Because of that, this man's name is not written in the Bible.
Y por eso su nombre no está escrito en la palabra.
No matter how much riches he had.
No importa cuántos bienes tenga.
He died and he left.
Él murió.
Nobody knows him.
Nadie lo conoció.
But you and I know Peter.
Usted y yo conocemos a Pedro.
No James.
Conocemos a Santiago.
John.
A Juan.
Because they left all.
Porque ellos dejaron todo.
And then they fell down. My prayer is that you make God priority.
Que hagan a Dios su prioridad.
But seek first the kingdom of God and its righteousness.
Que busquen primero el reino del Señor y sus riquezas.
Then everything else will follow.
Y todo lo demás se les
añadirá. There's going to come a time.
Va a llegar a un punto.
When those who have made God priority.
Que cuando todo aquello que haya hecho a Dios su prioridad.
God begins to elevate them.
Si tú los va a elevar.
And my prayer is that you become one of them.
Es que ustedes van a ser.
And this is my prayer.
Es mi oración.
That when God comes into this assembly.
Cuando el Señor entre esta asamblea.
To look for a man.
Que va a buscar a alguien.
To look for a woman.
Una mujer.
To look for a boy.
Un niño.
To look for a girl.
A una niña.
To honor.
Para darles un
your name will be first on his list.
Va a ser primero en esa lista del nombre del Señor.
Because God is a God who honors.
Porque Dios es un Dios que honra.
I'll teach about the rewards next week.
La semana que entra hablamos de las recompensas.
There is nobody.
No hay nadie.
Jesus said it. He said, there is nobody who has left wife, who has left houses, who has left everything else, and followed me, who have not received in this world. So it's not the other world. Right here. Somebody say right here. You receive it right here. What God has done in my life.
Lo que el Señor ha hecho en mi vida.
There's no way I can deny it.
No hay nada que pueda negar yo a Dios.
Because I saw where I was.
Porque yo vi donde estaba.
I saw what he did.
Vi lo que hizo.
And I saw what he's done.
Y vi lo que ha hecho.
And I can see what he's about to do.
Y veo lo que ya va a hacer.
He's not finished with me.
Todavía no termina conmigo.
And so I'm telling you from experience.
Les digo de experiencia.
That when you submit your life unto God totally.
Rinden su vida completamente al Señor.
He made something beautiful out of your life.
Hace algo maravilloso de su vida.
And he's about to visit in
y
you.
Los va a visitar.
That is why he's bringing you this word.
Es por eso que les trae esta palabra.
Anytime God brings his word.
Cuando el Señor trae su palabra.
It's because he's about to do something.
Es porque ya está a punto de hacer.
What is the cost of discipleship?
¿Qué les costaría hacer
discipleship? Deny yourself.
Niéguense a sí mismo.
What does deny yourself mean?
¿Qué quiere decir eso?
Refuse to recognize its existence.
Renunciar que existe.
Yes. Refuse to recognize the demands of your flesh.
Renuncia a las demandas de su carne.
Because your flesh will always want some things.
Porque la carne siempre va a querer cosas.
That are contrary to what God wants for you.
Están contrarias a lo que el Señor quiere.
Your flesh will always want to retaliate.
La carne siempre va a querer venganza.
Your flesh will always, want to get back.
La carne siempre va a querer tomar propios cuentas.
Your flesh always wants entertainment.
Siempre va a querer entretenimiento.
It always wants food.
Siempre va a querer comida.
Sometimes God doesn't want you off from entertainment.
Hay veces que el Señor les va a pedir que se quiten de todo entretenimiento.
Sometimes He wants you off from food.
Quizás a veces les pida que estén en ayunas.
When you deny yourself.
Cuando se niegan a sí mismos.
And you sow it unto Him.
Y se lo siembran al Señor.
That is when He can do amazing things for you.
Es cuando puede hacer cosas maravillosas para usted.
These guys were successful fishermen.
Estos hombres eran pescadores con éxito.
They denied him themselves.
Se negaron a sí mismos.
And they had to follow Jesus.
Y fueron tras de Jesús.
And God did something in their life.
Y Dios hizo algo en sus vidas.
Which I know He's going to do in our lives.
Y yo sé que también lo va a hacer en nuestras vidas.
Let's look at Mark chapter 8.
Vamos a Marcos 8.
Verse 34.
Versículo 34.
Mark 8, 34.
34.
When he called the people to himself with the disciples also, he said to them, whoever desires to come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever desires to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake and the gospel's sake will do what? Will save it. For what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? So the Lord is more interested in eternal things.
El Señor está más interesado en las cosas eternas.
When you give your life unto God,
cuando le entregas tu vida a Dios,
you deny yourself of things that you think you wanted.
Te niegas de lo que tú crees que quieres.
God gives you more than what you have been done for yourself.
El Señor te da más de lo que tú hubieras hecho para ti mismo.
If I look back,
si yo miro atrás,
this is not the life I was bargaining for.
Esto no era el tipo de vida que yo estaba en.
But when I denied myself and gave my life to God,
pero cuando yo le entregué mi vida al Señor,
He picked me.
Él me escogió.
He made a way for me.
Me hizo un camino.
And then He continued to make a way for me.
Y continuó a hacerme.
If I was rewriting my life,
si yo estaba escribiendo de nuevo mi vida,
I don't think I would have been where I was.
Yo no creo que hubiera estado donde estaba.
Settled somewhere.
Me hubiera puesto de complaciente en un lugar.
I was negotiating to become an X-ray technician.
Estaba negociando de convertirme en un técnico para los rayos.
Because I have messed up my high school life.
Porque yo me hice una prueba con la primaria, hice equivocaciones.
And the Lord said,
y el Señor dijo,
I have something better for you.
Tengo algo mejor para ti.
Because of your commitment.
Por tu compromiso.
I was in a covenant with him.
Yo estaba en el pacto con él.
My whole life up to now.
Toda mi vida hasta este punto.
Is God first.
Todo es Dios primero.
Everything else follows.
Todo lo demás.
Because I've come to understand.
Porque yo he entendido.
And when I make him first.
Que cuando lo hago a él primero.
He does things beyond my imagination.
Hace cosas más allá que lo que yo imagino.
I never had in mind.
Nunca tuve en mi mente.
That I was standing before you.
Que yo estuviera aquí parado delante de ustedes.
Preaching the gospel.
Dedicándoles el evangelio.
That I'll be in the foreign land.
Que estuviera en una tierra.
In a foreign language.
En un lenguaje que no es común.
And preaching the gospel.
Y predicando la palabra del Señor.
To a people. I mean, you are not here because of me.
No están aquí por mí.
You are here because God brought you.
Está aquí porque Dios me trajo.
And I see you as the hand of God doing it.
Y yo lo veo que es la mano del Señor en obra.
And I know that 6 months time.
Y yo sé que en 6 meses.
When we are in the other side.
Cuando ya estemos en nuestro hogar.
In our own temple.
En nuestro pueblo, en nuestra iglesia.
I mean, I've shed tears of joy already.
Yo ya derramé lágrimas de gozo.
But when we enter in,
cuando entremos,
I know it is the hand of God.
Yo sé que es la mano del Señor.
So there is nothing that God is asking of you.
No hay nada que el Señor les pida.
That He needs it.
Que lo requiere.
He's just asking you.
Más te lo pide.
Do you love me enough?
Me amas suficiente.
Do you trust me?
Me confías lo suficiente.
Do you want to commit your life into my hands?
¿Quieres comprometer tu vida en mis manos?
I know that when you put your life into His hands,
yo sé que cuando entregan su vida a él,
He does something amazing.
Va a ser algo maravilloso.
What else is the cost of discipleship?
¿Qué también es el otro costo?
You must clean or form new bonds.
Tienes que ponerte en
form new desires.
Tienes que convertir deseos nuevos.
John 21 verse 15. John 21.
Juan 21, 16.
There was a man called Peter.
Era un hombre llamado Pedro.
Yeah. And then the Lord told him,
y el Señor le dijo,
Peter, do you love me more than fishes?
Pedro, ¿me amas a mí más que los peces?
And Peter said, Lord, I love you.
Y le dijo, Pedro, yo te amo, Señor.
And then the Lord told Peter,
y el Señor le dijo a Pedro,
if you love me,
si me amas,
feed my lamb.
Entonces, dale de comer a mis ovejas.
So now, if you want to be a disciple,
ahora, si quieres ser un discípulo,
you don't live for yourself.
Ya no vives por ti.
You live for things that God is interested in.
Vives en las cosas que le interesan a Dios.
And I want to tell you,
y les quiero decir,
God's priority,
las prioridades de Dios,
is you.
Es tú. ¿Sí?
God's priority is your sister.
La prioridad de Dios es tu hermana.
His priority is your brother.
Tu hermano.
Because He came to save humanity.
Porque vino a salvar a la humanidad.
He didn't come to save material things.
No vino a salvar las cosas materiales.
He came to die and save human beings.
Vino a morir por el humano.
And He is interested in the growth and development of His people.
El interés de él es el que se desarrolle la gente.
So if you are a disciple,
si tú eres un discípulo,
your interest,
tu interés,
it should be in the people of God.
Debe de ser en el pueblo del Señor.
It should be the people at your workplace.
En la gente que trabajas con.
It should be how I can send the gospel to these ones.
¿Cómo puedo traerles el evangelio?
How can I be salt and light in my environment?
¿Cómo puedo ser la sal y la luz?
How can I bless this person?
¿Cómo puedo bendecir a esta persona?
How can I pray for the burden to be lifted up?
¿Cómo puedo pedirle al Señor que les quite la carga?
There are many people who behave crazily.
Hay mucha gente que se comporta mal.
It's not because they are crazy.
No es porque están mental.
It's because they have been possessed by demons.
Es que tienen posesión de demonio.
And it's It's time that we as believers, instead of being quick to judge in the physical, we go down on our knees and begin to pray for them and break the hand of the enemy. That's what we've been called to do. Also, if you want to be a disciple, submit yourself to teaching. Matthew chapter 5 verse 1.
Mateo 5, versículo 1.
Bible says that the disciples came.
La palabra dice que los discípulos vinieron.
And Jesus taught them.
Y Jesús los enseñó.
So, if you want to be a disciple, submit to teaching.
Si quieres ser un discípulo, entréguense a la enseñanza.
In Matthew chapter 11 verse 1.
Mateo 11,
1. Bible says,
la palabra dice,
Jesus gave instructions to disciples.
Y Jesús les entregó instrucciones a los discípulos.
So you must submit yourself to instructions.
Tienes que sumergirte a los
In Jeremiah chapter 3 verse 15, the Bible says, I will give you pastors after my own heart, who will feed you with knowledge and understanding. So you don't get to choose your pastor, just as you don't get to choose your parents.